It was a Monday morning, quiet-like. I was sitting at my desk enjoying the daily cup of joe and browsing the old tweet horn when the dame blew in. She was all kitten heels and crocodile tears and looking for my help.
Didn't anyone ever teach you to knock?
Well, I'm sorry, but you've got to help me. My husband thinks I've had an affair.
Well, did ya?
How dare you? The problem you see is my husband and I, we both have brown eyes, and the baby's got blue. And my husband thinks I've been off cavorting with some blue-eyed cat, some stub, but it's not true, you see.
The broad kept yammering, but I'd already spotted her problem.
I've never cheated, I've never strayed, I've never done anything wrong.
You stumbled across some biology, doll, and if you've got the dough, I'll explain it right to you. She nodded that she had. Fine, you've just found a recessive gene, you see?
A what?
A recessive gene. Now we'll go back to the start. You get one copy of each gene from your mother and one copy of each gene from your father. And sometimes these genes come in two varieties, dominant and recessive. So let's say you get a dominant allele from-
Allele?
It's like the flavor of a gene. Genes that have multiple types are said to have multiple alleles. For example, those earlobes hanging off of those seashells of yours. They could be hanging or they could be attached. And those possibilities are determined by which alleles of the earlobe gene you get. You could get the hanging varieties or the attached varieties. You follow?
I think so.
Well, all right then. Let's say you have two alleles for eye color. One of them gives you blue eyes and the other gives you brown eyes. Now you get one copy of the gene from your mother and one copy of the gene from your father. And they could be dominant or recessive. So let's say here that brown eyes are dominant and blue eyes are recessive. If you have two copies of the dominant brown gene, you'll have brown eyes. If you have two copies of the blue-eyed recessive gene, you'll have blue eyes. But if you have one copy of the brown-eyed gene and one copy of the blue-eyed gene, the dominant gene wins and you'll still have brown eyes.
Well, how is this supposed to help me?
I'm getting there, dollface. Give me a minute. Now, you and your husband were both probably carrying a recessive blue-eyed allele behind those big brown saucers of yours. Now, this here is called a Punnett square. You put your husband's alleles up top and yours down the side. Now you combine them in these boxes to see what combinations your child might have. Your little squirt's got a 75% chance of having brown eyes, and a 25% chance of having blue eyes, assuming you and your husband both had one copy of the brown allele and one copy of the blue.
So that's it? That's all? Why, thank you, I-
Not so fast, babe. There's a bit more. This is a nice example. You see, one they like to put in all the textbooks. But it ain't true and they ain't being square. There's more than just one gene that controls eye color, there's lots. That's why you don't have just brown and blue eyes in the world. You've got all different various shades and patterns. But this idea of dominant recessive genes, that's one to remember.
So what do I tell my husband?
You tell him you had an affair.
But I told you I didn't.
Well, didn't ya? And then just like she'd arrived, she blew out with a thundercloud, dropping little raindrops on the wood floor. That'd be the last I'd see of her. Or was it? Go forth, do science.